As far as fitness tracking goes, Fitbit has the market nailed. The brand name is now synonymous with steps counting and stats tracking, just like Hoover for vacuum cleaners and Hull for holes that no one in their right mind would ever visit. Unfortunately, the company's first foray into smartwatches wasn't very successful. The Fitbit blaze sunk pretty much instantly without a trace. Last year's Fitbit Ionic, however, was a massive improvement, offering lots of premium features such as NFC payments, offline music playback, and of course GPS support. Unfortunately, it was also £299, which is about the same price as an Apple Watch, making it a tough recommendation. That's why the new Fitbit Versa seems like such a promising prospect. Not only has the design been reworked to make it a slimmer, sexier model than ever before, but also the price has been massively slashed to just £199 here in the UK. So, is this the fitness-based smartwatch that we've all been waiting for? Here's our full review. Personally, we quite like the unique stylings of the Fitbit Ionic, but those sharp angles certainly weren't for everyone. Good news for the haters then, because the Versa sports a more typical rounded finish instead. That slender body is a pleasing change from the chunky norm. You won't find any frills or premium touches, but the aluminium frame is pleasingly curvaceous and also impressively light. You definitely won't feel this thing when it's strapped around your wrist. Of course, any past owners of the Pebble Time might get a serious kiss of deja vu when they first clap eyes on this bad boy. Fitbit loves to serve up plenty of choice when it comes to the straps, so you can customize your tracker and pimp it out for nights out on the town. And while the Versa comes with small and large rubbery straps as standard, you can grab additional bands for a bit of extra cash. There's something to suit all tastes, from leather and fabric to chunky metal mothers. And as the Fitbit Versa can track your swim sessions, it's not too surprising to discover this skinny chassis is water resistant as well, no need to wrap your arm in a Tesco's carrier bag or anything. In fact, this watch is good for diving to a depth of 50 meters, and it doesn't seem to mind the odd bit of washing up either. The Versa screen is a bit smaller than you might expect, as the surrounding bezels are rather chunky. Still, that 1.3 inch display is perfectly crisp thanks to the 300x300 pixel resolution. Viewing angles are great, and we had no problem seeing in strong daylight on that auto brightness mode. This thing tops off at 1000 nits to really punch through your retinas. Colours are pretty punchy too, which shines through on some of those more vibrant clock faces. Setup is relatively painless using the Fitbit app, which is available on iOS and Android devices, but you will want to go to the Fitbit website and check that your phone is one of the supported devices. We tried setting this up on the fresh new Huawei P20 and P20 Lite, and it wasn't having any of it when it came to the syncing. Once the Versa is synced with your phone, you can control and customize your watch using that Fitbit app, as well as checking your stats and bragging about how seriously bloody fit you are. Changing clock faces and downloading new apps is a piece of pie, and although that online store is a wee bit barren right now, we reckon it'll be well stocked in just a few more months. After all, Fitbit only started offering app downloads at the tail end of 2017. Although you could expand the functionality of the Versa using that store, there is plenty of great stuff already packed on to begin with. As usual, you get full notification support, which you can set up through the app. This seems to work just fine for checking out your messages, although there's no option for quick reply. You can also quickly check your stats or record your next workout using the exercise tool. And as ever, the Fitbit coach is on hand with a selection of training sessions to get you bang into shape. The only difference with last year's fully fledged and super expensive Ionic is the lack of GPS support, so that means you'll have to connect it to your phone if you want to map out your routes while you're roaming about the place. Still, it is impressive to see the likes of NFC payments make it onto this more affordable watch. Fitbit Pay is quick and secure and supported by any standard contactless receiver, just like your bank card or smartphone. However, the number of supported banks is a wee bit meagre right now, especially here in the UK. Right now, only Danske Bank and Starling Bank are signed up, so here's hoping that changes significantly in 2018. One of the best features, however, is that offline music playback. Hooking up to Bluetooth headphones is a cinch, and we had no issues with connection stability even when flapping about during one of our enforced jogging sessions. You can control the track playback and the volume as well direct from your smartwatch's face. There's now support for the Deezer streaming service, complete with a 3-month free trial subscription so you can check it out. There's just as much choice as Spotify on there, and the flow feature is a great way to check out fresh tracks. Actually moving your tracks over can be a real patience test at times, and the process occasionally falls on its arse, although the force sync option seems to work more often than not. And once it gets going, the sync process thankfully doesn't take too long. If you don't actually use Deezer and you're not really bothered about it, then you're stuck transferring your digital music albums over right now, and that's pretty much it. So here's hoping that Fitbit manages to secure a partnership with the likes of Spotify very, very shortly. One of our few bugbears with the Versa is its general performance. We wouldn't exactly describe the experience as buttery smooth. You'll witness little stutters and stammers here and there, although thankfully nothing that makes you want to pound your arm against a brick wall. As for the battery life, the Versa lasted anywhere between 4 and 5 days on a full charge, although of course if you're streaming songs and indulging in non-stop fitness tracking, then you can expect the battery to drain faster. While the Versa's performance ain't exactly great and it can be a little bit clunky in areas, there's no denying that it's a seriously slim and feature-packed smartwatch. The only thing we miss is that built-in GPS support, but frankly the massively reduced £199 asking price makes that a much easier bitter pill to swallow. If you want a full tour of the Versa's features and software and everything else, go check out our unboxing and hands-on review, and don't forget to give us a subscribe and ding that notifications bell if you want to hear more about the latest wearables, phones and everything else you need to know about. Thanks for watching, guys.